farmed out to friends and relatives constantly.
Yes, and put in her first institution when she was how old?
9, wasn't it?
9, isn't that great? And then because she couldn't stand being cooped up, she just kept escaping all the time.
The only charges against her are vagrancy. Being in need of care and protection, and what else?
Being in moral danger.
Oh, makes you laugh, doesn't it? Moral danger, and they put her in here. Yeah.
Bloody Joe Slater, she's got Susie, so she doesn't know where she is.
Oh, what's happened now?
Well, you know how she told Lizzie that she would go on with the mother bit for a while?
Yeah.
Well, this morning I caught her doing her damnedest to try and convince Susie that she wasn't her mother, and that was just before Susie had to go before the VJ.
Oh, great.
Come on, Bea, you've got to lean on that Slater a bit, because I reckon there is a chance she is Susie's mother and she's just too scared to admit it.
Listen, will you two shut up or either get out of here? Can't see I'm busy, I'm writing.
Well, what's crawling on her?
She's writing an article on Susie for the Weekly Star.
Well, that's going to be a bloody great help.
Shut up, Doreen.
Well, what's the good of writing a stupid bit in the prison paper about Susie when she's going to have escaped by the time it gets to print anyway?
Doreen!
Come along, dear. Let's let her get on with it, huh?
And this is the very same irresponsible behaviour that brought you to Wentworth in the first place. Do you enjoy being in here?
Oh, no. Oh, don't you see? That's why I tried to escape.
Well, you've simply got to learn that this is not the way you're going to get out. You must stay in here until the court decides you're old enough and mature enough to act as a responsible citizen.
I am. Why did they put me in here? I haven't committed any crime.
Technically, you have. And by these continuous attempts to escape, you're only making things worse for yourself. You must learn to pay for the consequences of your irresponsible behaviour. Now wait outside while we consider your case. Why can't she be like all the others? They're so much easier to deal with.
Don't you know what solitaire means?
Listen, I overheard what you were telling Susie this morning and I've been thinking. When did you say you were in Gippsland?
I didn't. I said I was in Mildura between 5 and 8 years ago.
Oh, yeah, that's right. What were you doing there?
I met my husband there. We've been married 7 years.
Got any other kids?
We've got one child, a boy, Jason. He's 7 years old. Anything else you'd like to know?
Yeah. You said you'd been married for 7 years.
That's right. Yeah. I was pregnant when we got married.
Huh. Seems you weren't above a bit of hanky-panky then.
It does happen, you know.
Come on, Doreen. Even you should know that.
Yeah, I know. But I think she's a callous bitch who doesn't give a stuff about poor little Susie. And she could be lying. You still could be Susie's mother.
You're wrong, Doreen. I like the girl a lot and I feel really sorry for her, but it's not going to help her in the long run. I am not and couldn't be her mother, no matter how much you or Susie or anybody else wants it.
Well, young lady, Mrs. Davidson and I have discussed your case, and we both agree that your actions deserve a lengthy extension to your sentence. However, you can thank Mrs. Davidson here for prevailing on me to reconsider and to give you one last chance to prove your good intentions. Therefore, I've decided to sentence you to 1 extra month to be served concurrently with your present sentence.
Oh, thank you, Your Honour.
But if you ever come before me again for escaping or even attempting to escape, I can promise you I will give you the absolute maximum possible sentence. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Very well. That's all. That should do it. I hope.
I hope you remember what the VJ said. Next time he'll throw the book at you.
I remember. I always do. They say that every time. Oh, but don't worry. I won't have to escape anymore. Well, not for a while anyway.
What are you talking about?
I can't wait to see the look on Mum's face when I tell her. She'll be really pleased.
Your mother? I didn't know that. When are you going to see her?
Well, she'll probably be in the rec room by now, waiting to go to lunch.
What are you talking about, Susie? Your mother?
Oh, Joanne, of course. She lets me call her Jo. Oh, you're not supposed to know. Oh, promise me you won't tell anyone. Or if they know, they might transfer her to another block. Promise? Good.
Oh, Lizzie's almost finished the cake. And she's also managed to get a few little extra goodies.
I bet she has. She could pinch the eye out of a needle.
Yeah. Oh, how'd you get her?
Well, he let me off. Well, actually gave me another month. To be served concurrently? Well, so it's the same thing, isn't it?
Oh, congratulations. That's terrific.
Yeah, good on you, honey.
That's great, isn't it, Joe?
Yeah, I'm really pleased for you, Susie.
We could show a bit more enthusiasm than that.
I said I was pleased for her.
Big deal. What more do you want, blood? You haven't got any to give.
Oh, knock it off, you two.
Yeah, nothing but an uncaring cold fish. You know what that kid needs, what she wants. You give it to her.
I can't and I won't.
Selfish bitch!
Stop it! Don't you dare talk to my mother like that.
It's all right, Susie. I can look after myself. And
well, you don't have to. Because I'm here now. Don't you ever speak to my mother like that again, Doreen. You've been very nice to me, and I like you. But Jo's special, and if you don't like her, you don't like me.
You don't have to protect me, Susie.
Well, we can protect each other now. Come on, sit over here with me.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Do you think it really gets the point across?
Oh, and how. You really feel strongly about this, don't you?
Yeah.
You can tell. It's all there on the writing. It's gutsy. Maybe a bit too gutsy here and there. You might have to tone it down a bit.
You censor one word, you don't use it.
I'm not going to censor it. It's just a few words, like here. Seeing we're aiming it for the outside press, I think we should use, say, utterly useless rather than not worth a pinch.
Okay, but I still think mine's more colourful.
It's good, B. It's really good.
Well, let's hope it stirs things up.
Here's the article. Who's available to set it up?
Slater can do it. Susie and I are checking over what we've just done.
Right, I'll be back in time for the first run of the press.
Right.
I'll help you. We'll get it done faster. It's all right, I can manage. Just let me read this first.
Susie, I'll need you to finish this. I'll help with the setup.
Oh, but I don't mind, honest. Look, I think it's better if Doreen helps me. She's had a little bit more experience. But thanks anyway. It's about Susie, the background, how she got to be in here. I didn't realise how awful it was.
You live and learn, don't you?
You should have seen her. I thought she was going to flatten Doreen.
I think the whole thing's gone on long enough. It's about time I had a word with Joe and found out the truth.
Yeah, well, Doreen's been working with him in the workshop, and she said she has serious doubts.
Well, it does seem a bit unlikely, don't you think?
Nothing would surprise me around here.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Listen, were you pleased with your article?
No, I had no Faulkner carried on about it, but I think it's all part of the con to keep me writing.
It's just that you still seem a bit low. I thought it would have cheered you up getting it out of your system.
No way. I think it stirred it all up.
What are you going to do if Joanne clams up?
What do you think?
Now?
Yep. Let her rip.
Very good. Congratulations, ladies. Well done.
Not bad, is it?
Not bad. It's terrific.
Oh. Isn't it great seeing it come off the press? All finished.
Yeah.
Here, Slater, you can start distributing these.
Oh, right. Where to?
I'll start with the laundry and make sure B. Smith gets one.
Okay.
Well, well, you must be a mind reader. I was just about to come looking for you.
Oh, well, I saved you the trouble. I was in the workshop. Here's the weekly stir.
That must be fascinating.
Well, open my eyes. I just read your article.
And?
Is it all true?
Every word of it. Why?
I just never knew the facts.
Oh. Didn't you?
Come on now, don't you start.
Let's stop pussyfooting around. There seems to be a question as to whether or not you're Susie's mother.
The truth is I am not her mother, but if you want proof, I suggest we go to the governor's office right now and ask to see my record or my file or whatever.
That's very nice, but not quite as easy as it sounds. Not too keen on handing around prisoners' records.